Hello students, so yesterday we did the Coulomb's law in a scalar form. The Coulomb's law in the scalar form was given by F is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 upon R square. This was the formula we have written when the two charges were in the free space or vacuum, where epsilon naught is known as the permittivity of free space or vacuum. Now let us see how the force of interaction changes when the medium is changed. Now if epsilon is the permittivity of medium other than free space, then so if we change the medium, suppose we have taken epsilon naught for the permittivity of the free space. Now if we change the medium, let the medium be water, kerosene, any other thing, the same two charges, same magnitude, are taken in some another medium, and remember they are kept at a same distance r. R was the separation between the two charges. So now we are taking the same charge and keeping the distance same in some other medium whose permittivity is epsilon, then F dash can be given as 1 upon 4 pi epsilon Q1 Q2 upon R square. So the force of interaction will change. So we take a new symbol F dash, where F dash is a force acting between the two charge kept at the same separation in another medium, or a medium another than the free space. We want to check whether the force increases or decreases. And if it increases and decreases, by how much time it increases or decreases. Now, if we take the ratio of equation 1 and equation 2, taking the ratio of equation 1 and equation 2, so F upon F dash is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 upon R square divided by this. So if you take the ratio of equation 1 and 2, you will get epsilon upon epsilon naught. The ratio comes out to be epsilon upon epsilon naught. This ratio is denoted by capital K. Yesterday, the small k was equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught, and small k was known as Coulomb's constant. Capital K is now a new ratio, and it is the ratio of the permittivity of the medium to the permittivity of the free space, or it is the ratio of force of interaction between the two charged particle in vacuum to the force acting between the same two charges kept at the same separation in some another medium. So where K, which is the ratio of two similar quantities, is known as the dielectric constant. This capital K is known as dielectric constant. So, what do you mean by dielectric, and how this word comes, that we will also discuss in second chapter. So, capital K is known as dielectric constant. Now, let us see what is the use of a dielectric constant. Now, from this equation, I can write capital K, which is equal to epsilon upon epsilon naught. So I can write epsilon is equal to k times epsilon naught. That is, permittivity of any medium is k times the permittivity of the free space, where k is some dielectric constant. So from this equation, we can say that is the permittivity of any medium is greater than the permittivity of the free space. Also, from this equation, I can write the force acting between the two charge in vacuum is k times F dash. It means the force acting in the vacuum is more than the force acting between the same two charge at the same separation is k times. That is, the force in vacuum is more than the force between the same two charge at same separation. So F will be more, and it should be more because we know from the previous equation that F is inversely proportional to the permittivity. So less is the permittivity, more is the force of interaction. So permittivity of vacuum is less than the permittivity of any medium, and because the permittivity of the vacuum is least, so the force of interaction between the two charge in the vacuum is greatest. So what is the conclusion from this? We can say permittivity, you have to remember this, permittivity of free space is least. Permittivity of free space is least. That is, the permittivity value is equal to 8.85 into 10 raised to minus 12 coulomb square per newton meter square. So yesterday or in the last lecture we have discussed the permittivity. So permittivity value is 8.85 into 10 raised to minus 12 coulomb square per newton meter square. So any other medium will have the permittivity k times the permittivity of free space, and therefore this permittivity of free space is least. And if we know the permittivity value, epsilon naught value, we take a Coulomb's constant small k, which was equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught. Now if I substitute the value of epsilon naught in this Coulomb's constant, that is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught, then its value comes out to be approximately 9 into 10 raised to 9, and the unit of Coulomb's constant will be reciprocal of epsilon naught. So its unit comes out to be newton meter square per coulomb square. So that is the value of k and the value of epsilon naught. So this is about the permittivity of free space and the Coulomb's constant for the free space. And another conclusion, this is first conclusion, that the permittivity of free space is least, and because the permittivity of the free space is least, the force of interaction, the force of interaction between two charges in vacuum is maximum or highest, because force is inversely proportional to the permittivity. So what is dielectric constant? Now we want to define a dielectric constant. We have two formula for dielectric constant. This dielectric constant is also referred as, and the another name is, relative permittivity of medium. Relative permittivity means with respect to vacuum. We will compare the permittivity of any medium with the permittivity of the free space, and from the ratio we can always find out that the permittivity of any medium will always be more than the permittivity of the free space. So dielectric constant is also referred as the relative permittivity of medium, that is capital K. And our formula will be, again I am writing, epsilon upon epsilon naught. So we can define it. So there, what will be the definition of dielectric constant? There are two formula, epsilon upon epsilon naught, or this was equal to force acting in vacuum divided by force in any medium. So we have a two formula. So if I say F vacuum, to F vacuum becomes K times F medium, matlab force in vacuum is maximum. Or if I say epsilon, to epsilon is equal to K times epsilon naught, so epsilon is greater than epsilon naught. So ratio, it is a ratio. So definition is, dielectric constant is defined as the ratio of the permittivity of the medium to the permittivity of the free space, or it is also defined as the ratio of the force of interaction between the two charges in vacuum to the force of interaction between the two same charges kept at the same separation in some other medium. So this is the definition of the dielectric constant. Now, since it is the ratio of the two same quantities, what will be its SI unit? It should be unitless. So dielectric constant is unitless, as well as it is dimensionless quantity. It is unitless and dimensionless quantity. So this is a Coulomb's law in a scalar form. Now how we implement the dielectric constant in the numericals? So a simple MCQ or a simple example is, suppose the force of interaction, the force of interaction between two charges in vacuum is 5 newton. So this is given, the force of interaction between two charges in vacuum is 5 newton. Find the force between two charges at same separation in water. And dielectric constant for water is 81, capital K. This is given. So capital K is 81. So our answer should be F vacuum, or we write F naught, not for vacuum. F naught given is 5 newton. Capital K given is 81. Now it should also be remembered that force in vacuum is maximum. Or if I take the ratio of K formula, so K is equal to F in vacuum divided by F in any other medium. Here the medium is water. So I can write the subscript Fw also. So K is equal to F naught upon Fw. Therefore, F naught Fw will be equal to F naught divided by capital K. And therefore, F water will be equal to 5 newton divided by 81. Now, this value, if we calculate, it will be less than 5 newton, which indicate that F naught is greater than F water. The force acting in vacuum is 81 times than in water, or force acting in water is 1 upon 81 times the force acting in vacuum. So F vacuum will be greater than F water. So this is one simple numerical. Now if I say another example, if I take epsilon naught is equal to 8.85 into 10 raised to minus 12 coulomb square upon Newton meter square. This is given in question. The permittivity of the free space is 8.85 into 10 raised to minus 12 coulomb square Newton per meter square. The dielectric constant of kerosene, this is capital K for kerosene, is 2 given. Now find out the permittivity of the kerosene. Now we should remember the permittivity of any medium is mole. So again, if we take the ratio of capital K was equal to epsilon upon epsilon naught, and therefore epsilon is equal to capital K times epsilon naught, and therefore epsilon is equal to 2 times the epsilon naught. So the permittivity of the kerosene is 2 times. So this is how we will use the concept of dielectric constant in various numericals. So you have to remember, if the medium is changed, the permittivity of the medium becomes K times the permittivity of the free space, and the force of interaction in any medium becomes 1 upon K times the force of interaction between the same two charges at the same separation in any other medium. After doing the Coulomb's law in scalar form, let us move to Coulomb's law in vector form. Now let us see the diagram. In vector form, we will take the two charges in any plane. So let us take two charges Q1, Q2 having position vector R1 vector and R2 vector as shown in the figure. Position vectors are with respect to origin. So R1 and R2 are the position vector of Q1 and Q2. And we are taking both the charges in XY plane. Now again, there will be a force of interaction. If both the charges are positive, there will be repulsion. Both the charges are negative, again there will be repulsion. If one is positive, one is negative, there is a force of attraction. Let us consider both are positively charged. So Q1 will be repelled away. So this is force on 1 due to 2. We call it force acting on 1 due to 2. And similarly, the second charge will also be repelled away. It will be named as force acting on Q2 due to Q1. Now we need to understand how the symbols or notations are given. Suppose I want to find out force acting on 2 due to 1. You can also find out F12. But suppose I need to find out F21. So I have to take this vector from Q1 to Q2. So head should be on Q2. So if I am finding F21, the arrow should be from Q1 to Q2, because the force is the force acting on Q2 due to Q1 is repelled. So I take the arrow from Q1 to, and I name this vector as R21 cap, matlab a unit vector which will give you the direction from Q1 to Q2. So R21 is a unit vector in a direction from Q1 to Q2. Let Q1 point be named as A, Q2 point be named as B. And this vector from Q1 to Q2, or AB vector, is named as R21, and it will be read as position vector of 2 with respect to 1. So try to understand the diagram. R1 and R2 are the position vectors. F12 is a force acting on Q1 due to Q2. F21 is a force acting on Q2 due to Q1. For direction, R21 is taken from Q1 to Q2, and R21 vector is called position vector of Q2 with respect to Q1. So in short, I am writing this R1 position vector of Q1, R2 position vector of Q2. So R1 and R2 are the position vector, F12 force acting on Q1 due to Q2. Similarly, F21 force acting on Q2 due to Q1. For direction, R21 a unit vector from Q1 to Q2. Q1 से Q2 की तरफ direction की जरूरत पड़ेगी क्योंकि vector form है. तो we will take the help of a unit vector. We know unit vector magnitude is 1 and it help us to find out the direction of the given vector. All unit vector gives the direction of any vector. And last is R21 vector. So I will call it a vector from Q1 to Q2, or it can also be called as position vector of Q2 with respect to Q1. Q2 से Q2 के रिस्पेक्ट में पोजीशन वेक्टर ऑफ Q2 विद रिस्पेक्ट टू Q1. सो दिस इज द डायग्राम फॉर कूलम्स लॉ इन वेक्टर फॉर्म. नाउ लेट अस ट्राई टू फाइंड आउट द फॉर्मूला फॉर F21 और फोर्स एक्टिंग ऑन Q2 ड्यू टू Q1. So, F21, in the previous lecture we know the magnitude is same whether it is F21 or F12, but their directions are opposite. Suppose I want to write out F21 in a scalar form. So, I will write small k Q1 Q2 upon, now the direction of R21 is denoted by the direction of F21 is denoted by the vector F, R21 vector. So distance will be R21 vector, uska magnitude upon square. Ye scalar form. This is the scalar form. Jo humne kal padha. Aur magnitude mein dal diya hai. Now if I keep an arrow on it, I need to write the direction of F21 also. तो F21 की डायरेक्शन को रिप्रेजेंट कौन करेगा? यूनिट वेक्टर. सो आई राइट आर कैप 21. तो आर कैप 21 का मैग्नीट्यूड 1 है. सो इट इफ दिस इज मल्टीप्लाइड बाय दिस मैग्नीट्यूड विल नॉट चेंज बट इट विल गिव द डायरेक्शन. और R21 का डायरेक्शन कहाँ है? Q1 से Q2 की तरफ. तो F21 का डायरेक्शन भी कहाँ होगा? Q1 से Q2 की तरफ. सो दिस इज the Coulomb's law in unit vector form. Now, in triangle OAB, O say Q1, Q1 say Q2, or O say Q2, that is a vector in triangle. So we have three vectors OA, AB, and OB. Now in triangle OAB, using triangle law of vector addition. Triangle law of vector addition लगाना है. So what is the triangle law of vector addition? If the two vectors are in the same order, दो vectors same order में हैं, तो resultant is a third side taken in opposite order. Same order मतलब head tail. तो यहाँ पे diagram देखोगे, तो OA vector plus AB vector, ये same order में कहते हैं, same order means head tail मिल गया, और head head मिल गया है, तो opposite order, so that is equal to OB vector. So if two vectors are in the same order, then the vector sum is equal to the third side taken in opposite order. Now what is OA? तो R1 vector, AB R21 vector है, इस तरह से OB R2 वेक्टर है, So
R21 is equal to R2 minus R1. This is equation 2.
तो जो डिनोमिनेटर में R21 है, we can replace it by R2 minus R1.
Also, unit vector R21.
Now, what is the formula for a unit vector? Unit vector is a vector divided by its magnitude.
So it becomes vector divided by its magnitude. Equation number 3.
So unit vector is vector divided by its magnitude, or R21 is given by R2 minus R1. So if we substitute equation 2 and equation 3, equation 2 or equation 3 को हम equation 1 में substitute कर देते हैं. So let us substitute equation 2 and equation 3.
So F21 is equal to K Q1 Q2.
अब यहां पे डिनोमिनेटर में इक्वेशन 2 को सब्स्टिट्यूट करें तो ये हो जाएगा R2 वेक्टर माइनस R1 वेक्टर के मैग्नीट्यूड का स्क्वायर. और R कैप 21 इक्वेशन 3 से देखें तो ये हो जाएगा R21 वेक्टर डिवाइडेड बाय R21 मैग्नीट्यूड. सो अगेन वी यूज इक्वेशन 2 हियर. R21 को आगे ट्रायंगल लॉ से क्या लेके आए हैं, R2 माइनस R1, तो ये हो जाएगा K Q1 Q2 अपॉन R2 माइनस R1 मोड का स्क्वायर. और अब R21 इक्वेशन 2 से R2 माइनस R1 और नीचे मोड ऑफ R2 माइनस R1 का मोड. So R2 minus R1 mod square, R2 minus R1 mod, दोनों multiply हो जाएंगे तो cube हो जाएगा. So our final equation F21 will be equal to K Q1 Q2 R2 minus R1 divided by the mod of R2 minus R1 mod का cube. This equation number 4 is called Coulomb's law in vector form.
So what is Coulomb's law in vector form? F21 is equal to K Q1 Q2 R2 minus R1 upon R2 minus R1 ka cube. This is Coulomb's law in vector form. Similarly, F12, F12 kya ho jayega? K Q1 Q2. Ab yahan R2 minus R1 hai. तो R1 minus R2 upon mod of R1 minus R2 mod का cube. This is our equation 5. So similarly F12 can be given like this.
So this is equation 4 and 5 will give you the Coulomb's law in vector form.
You see the equations, these two equations give Coulomb's law in vector form. How you have to remember it, कि किसके ऊपर force ढूंढ रहे हैं, 1 के ऊपर, तो force acting on 1 due to 2, K Q1 Q2, जिसके ऊपर force लग रहा है, minus दूसरे का position vector, यहाँ पे 1 के ऊपर force लग रहा है, तो R1 minus R1, नीचे उसका mod का cube है, mod will not affect if I interchange this R2 R1 minus R2 के जगह R2 minus R1 लग दो तो negative में answer आएगा, पर उसका mode again positive. नीचे हम उल्टा लिख भी दें या exchange कर ले तो नहीं फर्क पड़ता है, लेकिन this will give you the direction R1 minus R2 is not equal to R2 minus R1. So you have to remember like this कि 1 पे ढूंढ रहे हैं तो R1 minus R2, 2 पे ढूंढ रहे हैं तो R2 minus R1 हो गया. Both the equation
are Coulomb's law in vector form. It gives a force on 2 due to 1. It gives force on 1 q1 due to q2. Now this expression is when both the charges are positive. Both the charges are positive. So positive, positive, answer will be positive. Or both are negative. Negative, negative, again positive. But if there is a force of attraction between the two charges, अभी हमने repulsion consider किया, we have considered repulsion, but suppose we have attraction, so you have two options, either you interchange this, उल्टा लिखो, यहाँ 2 1 है तो r1 minus r2 लिख दो, नीचे फर्क नहीं पड़ता है, mod का cube है, mod है positive ही रहेगा, तो यहाँ minus यहाँ पे इंटरचेंज कर दो. This is one option. अगर attractive है तो उल्टा लिखो. उससे अच्छा take the product, एक positive एक negative. तो इनको उल्टा करने से अच्छा I will put a negative sign here. यहाँ पे negative sign. क्योंकि अगर एक one coulomb है और एक minus three coulomb है, तो directly we will write minus three instead of interchanging this. So if there is a force of attraction between the two charges, we substitute or we put a negative sign in equation 4 and 5. So this is Coulomb's law in vector form. एक बार इसको फिर से wind up कर देते हैं equations के terms में. Suppose I write f 3 4. If I write f 3 4, so I will read it as force acting on q 3. Due to q4. If I want to write it in unit vector form, small k q3 q4 divided by r3 4 vector ka square. Yahan pe r3 4 unit vector. This is in unit vector form. And since it is positive, there will be a force of repulsion. Now, if I apply the triangle law, it becomes k, q3, q4. किसके ऊपर फोर्स लग रहा है? 3 के ऊपर. तो तुमको लिखने का r3 minus r4. और डिनोमिनेटर में r3 minus r4 मोड का क्या हो जाएगा? क्यूब हो जाएगा. So, this is Coulomb's law in unit vector form. This is Coulomb's law in vector form. R3 minus R4 will give you the direction of the force acting. So we will see the numericals और हमको इससे क्या मिलेगा? Direction मिलेगा. Mode will give the positive value always. So when we will do the numerical, we will apply this concept. Now, let us write F4 3. So I will read it as force acting on 4 due to 3. In unit vector form, तो k q3 q4, यहाँ क्या हो जाएगा? r4 3 mod का square, so unit vector है तो नीचे square. Now this equations can be written as 3 4, तो 3 4 का direction क्या होगा? q3 से q4 की तरफ, और R cap 4 3 का डायरेक्शन क्या होगा? Q 4 से Q 3 होगा. तो बोथ डायरेक्शंस आर अपोजिट. सो आई कैन राइट R 3 4 cap इज इक्वल टू माइनस R cap 4 3. अब R 3 4 की जगह यहां सब्स्टिट्यूट कर दो इसको. सो F 3 4 इज इक्वल टू K Q 1 सॉरी Q3, Q4. अब 3, 4 की जगह मैं लिख रहा हूं माइनस आर फोर थ्री. सो माइनस आर फोर थ्री माइनस यहां लगा दिया डिवाइडेड बाई इट इज अ मोड मैग्नीट्यूड बोथ आर मैग्नीट्यूड मैग्नीट्यूड डिस्टेंस विल बी इक्वल डिस्टेंस बिटवीन 3 एंड 4 डिस्टेंस बिटवीन 4 एंड 3. सो डिस्टेंस तो सेम ही रहेगा या मोड है तो इट इज सेम. तो नीचे अगर हम चेंज करें नहीं करें उससे कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ता. सो आई हैव चेंज क्या किया है मैंने इस दिस इज इक्वेशन 1 दिस इज इक्वेशन 2 दिस इज इक्वेशन 3 3 को 1 में सब्स्टिट्यूट कर.
Now after substituting this, I find out कि ये जो क्वेश्चन है माइनस को छोड़ के वो तो इक्वेशन टू है मेरी. सो दिस कैन बी रिटन एज माइनस F43 वेक्टर. तो क्या प्रूव हुआ? F34 इज इक्वल टू माइनस F43 विच इज न्यूटन्स थर्ड लॉ. सो एक्शन एंड रिएक्शन आर इक्वल इन मैग्नीट्यूड बट अपोजिट इन डायरेक्शन. सो कूलम्स लॉ ऑल्सो ऑबे द न्यूटन्स थर्ड लॉ. सो दिस इज कूलम्स लॉ इन वेक्टर फॉर्म. सो वी एंड अवर टूडेज लेक्चर विद दिस टॉपिक. यू ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड द वेक्टर फॉर्म एंड इन द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर वी विल टेक वन न्यूमेरिकल विच हेल्प अस टू अप्लाई द कूलम्स लॉ इन वेक्टर फॉर्म. सो हैव अ good day students.